us right now. Holy Ghost, come on, let's all in. Help us ahead somebody, come in Christ's presence. Come on, let's go to the Holy of Holies.
Let your glory fill this place. Let your all-consuming fire fill this tabernacle and purify our hearts. Surround us in this place. Want you to breathe new life within us. Send a refreshing love. Let's ask for the rain tonight. Let's ask for the rain.
is my light and my salvation. Of whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? The Lord has been my guardian in all generations before the mountains. Wherever thou hast formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting, thou art God. Thank you.
We'll have everyone attention, please. Everyone attention, because life celebration is about to begin. We need everyone attention. Thanks so far for your cooperation. We know it's tight, but we'll get through it.
Thank you. Thank you for that hymn of comfort. Now you have the prayer of comfort by Reverend Dana Smith. Amen.
Lord, we thank you for hope. We thank you for life. We thank you for strength. We thank you for sound minds. And Lord, we thank you for this day that you have made. Father, we don't understand everything that encompasses the day. And Lord, you know we don't understand everything that encompasses a lifetime. But we put our faith and we put our trust in you. Oh Lord, we ask that you come in our midst right now. Oh Lord, we ask that you would fill us, Father God, and this place with your presence. Oh Lord, we pray that you would give us comfort. We pray for comfort of the family, Father. Lord, your word says that you are close to the brokenhearted. Oh Lord, I've known you many years, and I know that you are not the son of man that you should repent or a man that you would lie, but your God, you sit high and you look low. Oh, Lord, you never fail on one of your promises or on your word. Oh, Lord, so I know that you will come in our midst today. And Lord, you will send your angels just to minister to us, Father, as we are here to lay our loved one to rest. Oh, Lord, we love you, we adore you, we praise you, we magnify you, we lift you up. And we pray all these things in your son Jesus' name. Amen.
I'd like to thank Reverend Dana Smith for that prayer of comfort. Now we're going to have the readings from the Old Testament coming from Isaiah, the 44th chapter, starting at verse 10. 41st chapter, verse 10. Fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee, yea, I will help thee. I will uphold thee with thy right hand of my righteousness. May the Lord have blessed me with the word that is sanctified in our hearts. Now we're going to have the New Testament, Romans chapter 14. Verse 7 through 8. But none of us liveth to himself, and no man dies to himself. For whether we live unto the Lord, and whether we die. May the Lord have blessed you the word that is sanctified in our hearts. Now we're going to have a music selection of Amazing Grace.
Oh, a wretch like me. My first buddy, my friend, and I really love Rochelle. You know what I mean? And it hurt me the most part when Calvin came and told me. But we'll be quiet then. You know what I mean? She's gonna be all right.
Everyone, this is really hard for me today, but multiple times in my life, she's staying with me and my mother. It's really close, like, and she'll give me the shirt off her back. She's take me on all types of shopping trips, everything. She said that I was the daughter that she never had. She always wanted the daughter. She's like, Leah, you're like the daughter I never had. She always made you smile. If she didn't do anything else, she made you laugh. She always made us laugh. She always made you, oh my God, she know how to make you feel good about yourself. Like, I could be having a long day. She just come up to me like, Leah, oh my God, you're so beautiful, you're a supermodel, you know, she tell that, you know, that everyone that just, I'm lost for words, I'm so sorry, this is really hard for me, but I love you, I won't show, you know, my heart, this really hurt me. I'm gonna stay strong, Frankie, Nicholas, Darian, Danny, all y'all, you know, I love y'all from the bottom of my heart.
She loves all y'all. Sorry, thank you. Praise the Lord, everybody. For those of you who don't know, I am Rochelle's youngest sister, Heather. I have a lot of memories. For the sake of time, I'm going to talk about a side of Rochelle that a lot of y'all might not have even realized. Rochelle was an evangelist at heart. Anybody that knew her knew she was going to a church, she was taking Dare. She went to Bethel Deliverance International Fellowship of Churches. She took Angie, Lisa, Leah, all of us there. She went to BYOAB. She took all of us there as parents. A lot of y'all have been taken to church either in a building, through a conversation, through a scripture. Like Jewel said, Rochelle had a problem. She had a stuff. She had ups and downs. All of us have our thing. But at the end of the day, what she did, she had no idea what she was doing bringing people to Christ. Now, we could talk about the bad, but I'm going to focus on the good. Because even in her worst of days, she was bringing somebody to Christ. When I was down and out, and I didn't have nowhere to lay my head, she opened her door free of charge, didn't charge me a dime, never asked me for nothing. And just like you said, whenever I needed an uplifting word, she was there to uplift me. When I went through certain crises with my health, that's the person that I would call. Even if I didn't speak to her for months, we would pick up where we left off. So family, what I want y'all to do is not mourn her death, but celebrate her life, because she's in no more pain, no more struggle, no more breathing problems. She's home with the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, and that's what I know. Amen?
Rochelle picked me up. My mom was still on the bed when Rochelle picked me up as a newborn baby and picked me up in the air. I'm not gonna say the words that she said, but she made sure that I was gonna be up.
If you don't mind, my language should be I-T-T-H.
She wished that
I gave my mom all the problems that my mom gave me. One time, I'm just getting on this one situation. Just one situation. I said, Rochelle, I can't get my mom room. I can't. And she said, you know what you gotta do? Go in the kitchen and go get the mop. And bang it and get the long part and bang it as hard as you can. And trust me, she'll get up. I got my ASS book for that. And I was on punishment even though I took care of my mom. On punishment. My mom and Rochelle was like Bonnie and Clyde, and me and Danny was like Chucky and the Bride. Okay,
Rochelle's oldest brother, just like my pa, would have killed him to be here today. Glad you're here. That wasn't his favorite. And he always knew it. People say, parents don't have a favorite. They really do. But you know, you let them tell you that, and believe it. When you get all this, you look back, you see. Something about that more like, bro. Pop art.
Yep.
She could do no wrong. Nothing. No one could do wrong. Except for everybody else could, but she couldn't. And just kind of mad, was it? Just goes to what it should have been. My little nephews. Kind of determined. You know, these seven. Come out at your uncle, right? I don't know what y'all know. They've never seen all y'all in one spot. I've always seen you and you. You know what I mean? But just this crazy guy, I don't really know y'all. That's gonna change. So, you know, is this what it takes to make it happen?
Chance to actually meet Rochelle. I actually was supposed to meet her this summer, but I actually had a chance to talk to her on the phone. And I wish I had the opportunity to actually meet her. But then when my wife has told me how she was, we would have got along pretty good. So, hold up. I'm glad to be here in the ceremony. Sort of about it. It's a sad ceremony, but at the same time, it's a celebration. But I'm going next. You want to have the music selection? I need you.
Not a second or another. Not an hour or another thing. This moment with my arms outstretched. You take away and have done so many times before. Through a window, an open door, I stretch my hands. Come and rescue me. I need you right away. I need you now. I need you now. I need you.
Bear with me if I say some of these things wrong on the court, I apologize.
wishing you comfort. To love is to remember. Hoping you'll find some comfort in a warm memory you will always hold on to. Medina, Zane, Jacob, all the wine, and Melissa, and the wine. With love and sympathy, we will always keep her in our hearts. Deborah Washington, Tillman, and Family. With sympathy from both of us. May the precious memories of your loved one be comfort to you at this time. Deborah Tillman. She will on the side. We will miss Rochelle. Still can't believe that she's passed. I like to remember having dinner with her at Carrabba's. Her laughing. Great times. I wish you could see the heavenly view. How God knows what you're going through. How every hour he's by your side. Your faithful shepherd, friend, and guide. You can see his smiling face as he pours out his loving grace. Replacing fears with faith to stand. For he is the one who holds your hope. I will help you. I will hold on to you with my righteous right hand. Isaiah 41:10. Promises of God's comfort and hope. Jesus said, I am the resurrection of life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. John 11:25. God's love was revealed among us in this way. God sent his only son into the world so that we may live through him. Thanks be to God who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled and do not let them be afraid. May God's hope-filled promises bring comfort to your soul and peace to your heart. With heartfelt sympathy, love always. Darlene family. Resolution to the family of Rochelle Thomas. Whereas in the providence of God, who has worked to include the life of your beloved sister, Rochelle Thomas, the pastor and members of Mount Carmel Church of God in Christ, feel it be fitting to express our sympathy to minister and sister Christopher Robinson and family. We commend you to him who knows best and will always do right. Whereas Sister Heather Robinson and the family will continue in our prayers. We are indeed sad by the loss of your loved one. We know that she will forever be in your hearts with all the pleasant memories you hold so dear. Be it resolved that we bow in humble submission to him who never makes a mistake and remind the family to be encouraged by remembering this poem. When I must leave you for a while, please do not grieve and shed tears and hug your sorrow to you through the years. But starting bravely with a valiant smile, and for my sake and in my name, live on and do all things the same. Feed not your loneliness and empty days, but fill each working hour in deeply ways. Therefore, be it resolved.
Amen. Thank you for the cards and resolutions. Next, you will have the reading of obituary by Cheryl Whitfield.
Late parents Cheryl Thomas and William Thomas Jr. Rochelle was the only daughter produced from their union. Rochelle was raised in Jenkintown area by her aunt Dorothy and her late uncle Thomas Lewis. Rochelle, who was affectionately known by many names, including Roach, Reds, and Big Red, departed this life on Saturday, May 15, 2021. Rochelle was educated in the Abington School District and completed school in 1990. Always being current on the latest fashion trends and being creative, Rochelle attended the Jean Madden Aveda Institute, where she became a licensed nail technician. Her artistic style and her trendy nature made her popular amongst the best technicians. Rochelle always had Christ in her heart. In her early adult years, she attended Bethel Deliverance International Church, in Cheltenham, Pennsylvania, where she would bring everyone to hear the word. In her later years, Rochelle attended Burying One Another's Burdens Family Members Church, where her spirit grew and she would continue to love Christ. Rochelle was loud and full of life. She would talk for hours on the phone and always had a listening ear for everyone. She had a heart of gold, always so loving, caring, and helpful, and would give you the shirt off her back to anyone. If someone had a need, even if she didn't have it, Rochelle would give it. Rochelle had a love of words. She spent many hours reading and writing, especially poetry. In her many bags, she would have anything from magazines to hood novels or even a Bible. She loved doing crossword puzzles and Sudoku. Just like a big kid, Rochelle would sit and color and do arts and crafts with all the children. Rochelle was big on family and friends, and anyone who knew her couldn't help but love her. She was preceded in death by her parents, Cheryl Thomas and William Thomas Jr., and her two sons, Jamie and Aaron. She leaves to cherish her memory, her sons, Daniel, Darian, Justin, Jesse, Jamir, Frankie, and Nicholas. Her grand aunt, Dorothy Lewis, life partner, Calvin Washington, siblings, Bruce, wife, Cheryl, Inake, husband, Frederick, Keisha, husband, Victor, Tiffany, and Heather, husband, Christopher, and a host of nieces, nephews, aunts, uncles, cousins, and many family and friends. A poem to her siblings. Weep for me, though I have gone, into the gentle night. Grieve if you will, but not for long, upon my soul's sweet plight. I am at peace, my soul's at rest. There is no need for tears. With your love, I was so blessed for all those many years. There is no pain, I suffer not. The fear is now all gone. Put these things out of your thoughts. In your memory, I live on. Remember not my fight for breath. Remember not the strife. Please do not dwell upon my death, but celebrate my life. Love your sister. A poem to her boys. Don't cry for me. I always will be near. I know it doesn't feel like it. Just know I'm always there. Don't cry for me, though you may shed a tear. I know this loss for you is very great and difficult to hear. Don't cry for me. I know you're filled with fear. I did not want to physically leave, but this cross I could no longer bear. Don't cry for me. I am no longer in despair. I fought so hard to repair this life of mine, which has not always been fair. Don't cry for me. Please know I wanted to remain here, but in the arms of my Heavenly Father is where I am because he pulled me near. Don't cry for me when you think of me. No, I'm always near to look after you all. With tender love and care, don't cry for me. Know that when you are unaware, that in your time of questioning, God will wrap you in his love and kindness that is absolute and rare. Love, Mom.
Thank you for the reading of the obituary. I'm going to have a tribute of compassion, the funeral consultant.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen again.
Amen.
God is still good.
Yes.
And his mercy is everlasting and the truth and good to all generations. God plows on every hand. We cannot always understand all the ways that God will lead us to that blessed promised land. But he'll guide us with his eyes and we shall follow till we die. On On behalf of the Ricks Funeral and Cremation Service, first of all, we'd like to thank this family for blessing and trusting us to take care of their loved one during this hour of grief. Our continued prayer that God will continue to keep you strong, stout, and stable, just like the tree that's planted by the rivers of water. Fans, friends, family, and loved ones, you might be sitting here wondering what next. But the Apostle Paul said, now abide in faith, hope, and love, love being the greatest one. We have faith enough to believe this morning that our dear sister is going on to be with the Lord. Because the Bible said to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. And we still have that blessed hope that if we hold on to God's unchanging hand and if our testimony remains true, we'll see our dear sister again. But it says, love, which is the greatest one. Love never dies. Love extends beyond the grave. We'll always have a love, a life, a memory. And I heard somebody said that she was a Bible student. We'll always have her witness. How she witnessed to her family. We always have that. But lastly, but not least, in the days to come, before a smile will come across your face, before your eyes are filled with tears for the joy that she has left behind. Now at this time, a minister of music will minister to you. Let this song bless your heart. May God keep you and heaven smile upon you.
You are the source of my strength. You are the strength of my life. So I lift my hands in total praise to you. Lord, I will lift my eyes to the hills, knowing my help is coming. Your peace you give me in time of the
Mr.